that, chilling, you know what I'm saying, living. All my niggas is living. Where I think I'll be, 10 years, I don't think I'm gonna see a dog, for real, man. That shit ain't promised, man. And I don't think my luck is that good. I hope it is, but if it ain't, so be it. I'm ready.
I wouldn't mind being the world champ, but I'll do whatever it takes to get there. And if I don't get there, I hope somebody else from Hawaii does.
Well, it's the brothers from the city of Sunshine and Sunset Beach where bikinis swing every single week, either daytime, nighttime, anytime's the right time. So welcome to the spot where every day is like the summertime. Smoking up a fatty in the Fleetwood Caddy, Big Daddy JD.
On day one, Papa T.
How about to show you how we do it in the HIC? Know what I mean? My paradise, known for the green.
Only the A1 Dank got a place in my Vegas. An everyday thing from the Paradise Players. Rolling in the daytime into the night, Tangerine. Pineapple got us feeling all right.
How he started surfing was the kid across the street gave him, known him an old surfboard. And so the two of us would go out there. So he'd be out there dog paddling, and I'm going, don't you dare, drunk. Because I don't know how to swim. I still don't know how to swim.
And relax on this blue.
When I first met Sonny, it's my first memory of him when I was about 4 or 5 years old. And there's a sandbox right here. I was playing in my sandbox and I just heard this noise. He used to do this thing with his hand like a...
Yeah, I remember Jason saying, yeah, Sonny's coming down the trail. So, you know, don't make any noise. Pretend that nobody's home.
Yeah, we're coming up from the west side. Everybody
knows that it's big. Sonny passed the Magellan at his house every day on his way to a place called Shallows where he first learned to surf. From day one, he was hooked. He practically lived with the Magellan family and surfed nearly every day with Sino's sons, Jason and John.
That's how we float when we're kicking it on the down low to let you know it's big every time from the get-go.
You know, about 8, 9 years old, we've seen him at Miley. And then Real Sons Mini Hooney Contest. 9 to 10 years old, I think he was in.
And he got his first win, and after that, non-stop, you know, every single contest, win.
Started winning everything in sight. I think I remember he was counting winning streak he had of heats, and it was something like maybe 50 straight or something like that. This was when he was probably 13 or so.
Surfing was the first priority in Sonny's life. Everything else took a back seat, including homework. Sonny rarely missed a day at the beach, but the same couldn't be said about school.
He couldn't concentrate in school because he went to Waianae and the ocean is right there. So
I don't have too much memories because I work this area every day. And every time I get waves, I know that boy's not going to be in school, so, you know, I never did see him quite often, but when he's in school, he's on Rascal, yeah? Just, I can't remember. I worked here 30 years, but they call me Silver.
There's times where he cut out of class and come down the beach, and I would take away his surfboard and tell him, sit next to me in the tower and wait till all the kids out of school and let the kids surf and let him watch, you know, just so he learned.
When Sonny was in 9th grade, I don't know if you could call it 9th grade because he didn't go to school that much, but...
When he started going to school, he'd be there like 6 o'clock in the morning, out there on the beach, before school, after school, then it was like during school.
You know, we desperately all tried to get Sonny to stay in school, After that meeting, it was totally apparent he wasn't going to stay in school, so we all tried our best to help him with his surfing career, and we all felt that was the best choice for Sonny, and I think it turned out really good for Sonny. He surfed like a grown man. I mean, he was like one of the best surfers in the world at like 14 years old.
He first joined the Macaw surf team at the age of 13 and would adapt the same no-fear approach to competition as his first coach, Bird Mahilona.
You gotta turn it a bit more harder. You gotta come straight up. You can't go halfway. You gotta go 12 o'clock. And he used to look at me. He used to get, you know, he go, what? No way I can do better than you. I go, you know what? You never be as good as me. You never make it to the circuit. You never gonna make it on a circuit. You know what? I seen the determination in his eyes. I mean, I used to psych him out to the point where he's, you know, he wanted it so bad, and yet he didn't even taste them yet.
I was at Macaw, and was called a Paradise Pro, and I think Sonny was 13 at the time.
Although he dominated the amateur ranks, Sonny's first chance to test his skills against the pros like Dank Hilloha, Marvin Foster, and Michael Ho came at the Paradise Pro. A solid showing in the quarterfinals of that event reassured Sonny that he was ready to run with the big dogs.
You can see the form, kind of like a pretzel, but you know, the kid was gonna make it, you know. Well, it's the
H-A-W-A-R-I-A-N. A couple of weeks prior, my anger temperament got me kicked off the world amateur team for Hawaii.
Sonny never knew, before you knock the door down, you gotta loosen up the hinges.
How far do you plan to go, Sonny?
I plan on going all the way.
It was clear Sonny was ready to take the next step. The Gotcha Pro at Sandy Beach is where Sonny Garcia would make his mark on professional surfing.
I wanted to turn pro and I'm like, yeah, that's it. If I do good next week in the Sandy event, I'm gonna go on the tour.
And there he goes, Sonny Garcia from Hawaii, another way to go, all the way to the beach. Looking good.
To me, till this day, that Sandy Beach event, the Gotcha Pro, is my most memorable, you know, best result that I've probably ever had in my whole career. You know, my first AFP, you know, contest.
Sonny Garcia, fought hard, recorded on 100%, but those long eyes on the beach told the story.
Really, the bad thing in Sonny's career was he never learned how to lose in the beginning.
Is there such thing as a good loser?
Yeah.
Bullshit.
I'm not going out there to lose. I'm in it to win. If I'm there, entered in the event, I'm there to win. I don't care if there's no money up. I want to win.
Made it to the final and just killed Tom Carroll in the final. So, you know, my first win was a pretty big one for me.
The Sealand Pro was, you know, in 1990. It was a week after the Phuket contest that I'd won. You know, same scenario. I surfed against Derek in the quarters. I think I surfed against Damian Hartman in the semis, and then I surfed against Gary Elkerton in the final. And the final was, you know, pretty close. I think I beat Gary Elkerton by 0.01. For me to win my first event the week before is pretty big, but you know, to win back-to-back events was insane for me. In the 1994 reunion final, I remember the final almost, you know, being really inconsistent and just having to take any wave, and I was actually losing, and with I think like 2 minutes ago I needed a six, and I got a, you know, okay wave, did a couple of turns and did a huge floater at the end, and they ended up giving me a seven and ended up winning the final. You know, it was an insane final. I mean, that was the year John had just made it back on the tour, and you know, to surf against John in the final was incredible. But you know, he was surfing really good and the waves are small, and I think I got a 10 in the final. I got a 10, a 9, and an 8, and Shmoo had, I think, a 9 and 2 8.5s, and you know, it was a really close final. And
Sonny, I'll tell you what, Sonny Garcia and the White Summit is going absolutely berserk. The waves are bruised. He's tore that one apart.
It was just insane, the surf against Shmoo, and you know, in our first final league together in the ASB event. You know, in 95, I mean, that was, you know, the year I was going for the world title, and, you know, I think I, you know, I had to beat Derek to win the Sud Quest. It's like a, you know, the Triple Crown of France, and I had to beat Derek in that final, so, you know, for me, it, I mean, you know, to serve against Derek's always competitive, and to beat him in the final was insane, and not to mention, you know, I got 15 grand for the Sud Quest trophy, and... And you know, put me right in contention for the world title.
I don't actually think at any given time there is a best surfer in the world. I think there's so many surfers that are so talented, that surf so good, that on any given day anybody could be the best surfer in the world. But to be the world champion is a whole different, you know, story. You know, it's all about traveling, being the most focused, the most, you know, the best surfer to able to compete in small waves and big waves and choppy and smooth and everything. That's what the sign of a champion is. And you know, I've come close, but you know, everybody that I've lost to, well, mainly Kelly, you know, and Aki, you know, they were able to put it together, you know, a little better than I have in a year, and I respect them for that. And you know, that's what I aspire to be. You know, I want to be the world champion.
Then when you see him come home for the Triple Crown, or you know, maybe before that, you meet him in California for a big contest up there. Oh, you know, it's so warming, you know.
You know, I'd rather win in Hawaii, where all the people I know and my family are, than to win anywhere else. It's important for the Hawaiians to win in Hawaii. So, you know, if none of the other Hawaiians make it, you know, I want to definitely be there and win.
Very aggressive and powerful surfer. He loves the big waves of the North Shore, as does this man in white, Sonny Garcia, the local favorite.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you our Coors Light Triple Crown winner for 1993. Give it up for Hawaiian Sonny Garcia. Oh yeah! Congratulations, Sonny.
Sonny Garcia, the Hawaiian winner of the Triple Crown event.
His surfing's gotten better and better and better and better each year.
Claim when you need a 9.5 at the end of your heat and you get it, or at least you think you got it.
Gotta be multilingual, multi-talented, you know,
multi-financial. You gotta understand how to deal with the money, you know, exchanging and stuff like that. So, like I said, Sonny went to school, but was on different school, the school of life.
Yo, players, it's game time.
International player, him are the island warrior, yeah. International player, I fire up your Garcias now.
Sunrise to the eyes, mind blinded, prepare for the vision in the net. Listen.
I think the bottom turn is a very, very important thing. There's a lot of guys that don't have them that are on tour.
Forfeit your paradise. Warriors born to dust, bust till it's twilight. Exotic beaches, mashy poses and leeches. Learn to swim before you kick 2D6 speeches. And we push real waves like masterpieces for the brave. Enslaved by the blaze of the leaders and his day. Upon this crew, true animals out the zoo. Real crew come through and snatch beach breaks like axe on break beats. Take surf meets to reef, makes these hoes achieve. So all you motherfuckers just hit the ocean floor. Next time, Sun G flaming back doors.
Everybody goes about doing things in a different way, and I wouldn't say that exactly, you know, the way that I went about doing things when I was younger was the right way, but I'm not going to make any apologies for it. That was me, and you know, it's got me to where I am today, and I'm definitely not sorry for it.
Let me ride, sunny to cloudy, we ride a rally. Can I have this situation? Ain't you wrong? Could it move? No hesitation. Slide and ride, represent the west side. Better for the rest on a lot of gear. Organization that we drive and lots and that the same time. Play by the sunny day, give me two, so we're gonna do. Make a move, fly past.
You gotta have the power. You get the power, surfing coming back. We're the only guy with the long hair. Okay. You get some power, sunny get the power. I think sunny get more Hawaiian style. You know that guy?
Back again and try with a proper mouth, never quit. Time, so you know how we do it. And since a kid, you screw it, do it up with every chance. Feel like after the pan, going to back to get that money, man.
I think, you know, power surfing is a lot better than someone that's flicking. And, you know, I think it looks a lot better.
One thing about what builds success for us guys is we set attainable goals. We know what we want and we know how we're going to get them. And there's nothing that's going to stop us guys from getting them. You know, so I know Sonny going to be one world champion. You know, in my heart, he is one world champion.
I want to at least win one world title before I retire. And, you know, hopefully this will be the year.
For me, this, you know, the beginning of this year, I mean, it was... Everything just kind of fell into place. You know, I trained really hard, you know, during the Triple Crown, I mean, all through the Triple Crown, I, you know, lifted weights, ran, you know, and surfed a lot. Everything just kind of flowed. I just, you know, went to Australia really confident, just like surfing pine trees, just a little bigger, and, you know, got to the final, and Flavio was kicking my butt in the final. I couldn't get waves, couldn't get in the rhythm, and, you know, I was starting to settle for second, and that's when I, you know, thought that, you know, second wasn't good enough, and I dug deep, and I think I got three waves in a row that ended up helping me win that event.
Big hand, awesome performance all throughout the day. 3,000.
I heard Sonny won the first one. I said, yeah! And he took the second one. I went, wow! So that was a, you know, a good start.
Yeah. And up and running, Sonny Garcia. Ball taking off, getting very deep inside a very, very solid wave indeed.
You never see anyone pound it so hard and so wicked, like nothing.
Sonny Garcia in the white, you need a 6.91. You see Sonny just taking off backside, getting a nice little cover up. Fading deep, it's a nice little hook in the pocket there for Sonny Garcia.
One of the heaviest, well, probably the most heaviest wave that I've ever surfed.
Huntington was a pretty important event, you know, to do well in. I knew that, you know, a lot of the small wave guys were hungry to do well. You know, guys like Taj and Jake and you know, a few of the other guys that were close to me in points. And, you know, I just came off a string of 3 nights in a row, you know, Tahiti, Fiji, and Jay Bay, which for me were the events that I thought I was going to do really good in. And, you know, I came to Huntington and I worked on some boards and had some really good boards and felt confident. And, you know, fortunately for me, Taj lost early, Luke lost early, Jake lost early, and the only guy that was actually really close was Corey Lopez, and I was, you know, fortunate enough to beat him in the semis.
Years on tour, I've never got a free heat. Going into Brazil, I knew that Luke needed a first and a second, and that Jake needed to win both Brazil and Pipe, and I needed to lose in, you know, the first round of both events, which was not going to happen. So
yeah, I'm pretty happy. I mean, every heat I make is a little closer to clinching that world title.
Well, for Kalani, it was incredible. I was stoked for him. You know, it's been a long time coming. You know, he's been expected to do a lot better than he has, and you know, hopefully now that he's got his first taste of victory, you know, he'll take it a long ways. It was pretty incredible, man. You know, Brandon win his first event. You know, at the same time I won my first world title. It was pretty incredible.
To win at anything is incredible.
Travel easy, the plane ride not a hassle.
Leaving Hawaii and the good ways that we do to go surf and some of the places we do,
That is the job of it. The surfing part is the easiest thing. But, you know, just having to travel and be away from home and your friends, and especially when you call home and, you know, they're like, hey, you know, back door is like 6 to 8 and the best has been all year, and, you know, you're off in Brazil and the waves are 2 feet and then, you know, you're in your 3 mil full suit. You know, that's what you get paid for. That's what actually, you know, that's what I get paid for, to leave Hawaii and surf, you know, on the tour.
Surfing is an adventure, you know, it's a thing that you really want to do when you're young. And then when you're doing it, you start traveling around in all of surfing areas around the world. And after a while, you get tired of it because you just want to stay home after a while and enjoy Hawaii.
You can't describe. Yeah, I don't think you could ever describe to a person that hasn't been barreled, you know, what it's like in a barrel. You know, the view is so incredible. You can see people paddling out, or you can see, you know, back there you can see the houses that are off the wall, and everybody standing on the beach. So it's beautiful.
Young, I seen the fire in his eyes that one day, not knowing he was going to be one of the best coming out from the west side and surfing hard as he is, and I just thank God for blessing him with everything that he's doing right now. And I knew it from when he was young. Out of everybody, you know, I talked to him, I psyched him out, he let get it on, bro. He was ready to get it on in his own, and there was something about him out of all the kids that I've trained. One day, you know, the best.
Yeah.
I'd also like to thank all my sponsors. You know, they're all here.
Why not?
Mark and Brian Simo from No Fear. BYB, who are also here, Wendy and Glom, and my family from Phuket are here.
Yeah.
They made that long flight from Spain. Misha from Warriors are here. Spy Sunglasses. It's been a great year for me. I'd also like to thank all my boys back here, all in black. I love all of you guys. You are my boys, you're all you will be. Thank you.
Nice to see another Hawaiian in there.
Yeah.
We only got a handful of them out there on the tour, so just to get one of them to win it, I think that says a lot. You know how to do it. Make me proud.
Yes, he's the man and disputed champion. Yes, I'm eager to say that you are white. Yes, he's the man and disputed champion. Yes, I'm eager to say every set of white. A surfer man to pro from a 16 years old. Them in his competition from a low for Ivy World. Fire in his eyes with the big ways to kill. What his sponsors realize, a white man got skills. From that side to front, son, they give you what they want. A cake hero, my dog, them see.
Sonny's gonna get stronger. I think he's gonna be around for a long time. I'm proud of him, and I hope him the greatest success.
Growing up as a young boy, the ocean called his name.
Sonny,
a product of the West Side, destined for fortune and fame. Full of
desire,
he was inspired to be the best that he could be in the surfing industry. But it didn't take long. At the age of 16, he turned pro and started surfing worldwide. Sharing with the world his Hawaiian pride, yeah. Now he's a hero. All the white people.
Bro, you see that waves out here? You should work right here. Me, I put down my rig and my scooper. I leave my pack of cigarette 2 miles over there. I jump off, I go rip. Sonny, nothing. Chaskin, Richard Silva, bro. I still get them, bro. Bird Mahilona, you should surf with them, bro. You know me, bro. Richard Silva. Come on.
Everybody know me, though. That's Uncle Buff, Mel Poots. That's all the boys down there. They know me. Richard Silva, ma.
Ain't nobody talking shit no more. Blind, blind, bodies moving, keep it in hardcore. Blind, blind, ain't nobody know what I have been taught. Blind, 20 times, ain't shit more. Blind, blind, ain't nobody talking shit no more. Blind, blind, bodies moving, keep it in hardcore. Blind, blind, ain't nobody know what I have been taught. Blind, 20 times, ain't shit more. Blind, blind, ain't nobody talking shit no more. Shit no more, blam blam, bodies moving, keep it in hardcore, blam blam, ain't nobody know what I happened.